Now about the indicators of development. Indicators of development. What is the use of these indicators of development means? Here it is used in order to measure the development. That is how much development is taking place in order to measure that one. As we measure different articles in different manner, here in the by using these indicators we measure the development. Here first indicator is the income indicator. Income indicator. On the basis of income we calculate the measurement, we calculate or measure the development. Here the national income will be taken into consideration. If the higher is the national income, higher is the development, and low is the national income, low is the development. Here on the basis of national income, on the basis of national income we measure the development. Higher the national income, higher is the development. Lower the national income, lower is the development. But here in this if we take into national income into consideration, it is not a, that is good criteria. Why? Because the national income may be more, but here the distribution of national income will not be proper. That's why here it is not a good calculation of national income, because in a country national income is rising. But more than national income, the population is increasing means it is not a development. For example, like in our India and other countries of the world, development is taking place. Income is increasing, but more than income, population is increasing. That's why national income cannot be a good criteria to measure the development, because of the increasing of population. That is, increasing population will not be favorable for the development. For example, if we take into consideration the USA, Japan, Germany and those countries, the national income is increasing, but the population is not increasing. That is faster there. Because of that reason, those countries can considered as a developed countries. But in India, national income is increasing, but more than income, the population is increasing. That's why what is to be taken into consideration, which is another criteria to be taken into consideration, that is the per capita income. Per capita income is the another indicator to measure the development. Per capita income means the total population of a country, total, that is a national income taken into consideration, total national income is divided by the total population, and then the outcome will be the per capita income. Here this total national income is divided by total population is taken into consideration, and at that time we try to know about the distribution of income, as well as whether a country is a developed stage or underdeveloped stage on the basis of per capita income. This is the second. Then this also is not a good factor, because here the concentration of wealth in few hands, and here their income is also in the per capita income divided, but in reality they are having a very less income. That's why per capita income is also not a good criteria to measure the development, because here the income, rising of income, it is doesn't mean that even all people are getting all type of facilities here. That's why the what is the next thing to be taken into consideration in order to measure the development, and that lead to the other parameters to measure the development, that is called as the human development index. Other parameters. First, national income as a parameter or a indicator, and per capita income is a indicator, but real figure we can't get from this one. That's why other parameters are adopted in order to measure the national, that is the national development or economic development of a country. That is called as human development index. Here, what is this human development index? And every economy is having a primary aim. Every person that is economy is having a primary aim, that is the human welfare. Human welfare is the primary aim of every economy. What is the human welfare? Providing all the basic amenities to the people. Basic amenities to the people. Everyone is getting those basic amenities like food, shelter, clothing, and that is water, clean water, clean environment, and each and everything they are getting, that is called as basic amenities. If they are available, that is called as a real development. Here, increase in a country's income, it doesn't mean that everyone is getting these basic amenities. Because some are having billions of rupees, some is having millions of rupees, and some are living very below poverty line. For example, in India, more than 20% of the people are living below poverty line. On the basis of income, we cannot decide that they are having all these kind of basic amenities. They are denied of these basic necessities. That is, on the basis of that one, how we can calculate the development. Here, two important economists' views are taken into consideration here. As national income as well as per capita income is not a perfect criteria to measure the development, a new concept is a human development index. Human development index is another parameter to measure the development. This concept was developed by particularly two important economists. Among them, one of a Pakistani economist by name Mahbub ul Haq. And this Mahbub ul Haq was influenced from one of a important Indian economist by name Amartya Sen, a Nobel laureate in economics. And this, what Mahbub ul Haq says, the development of a particular country can be understood and can be measured by having a human development as a factor. Human development as a factor to measure the development. What is there in the human development? That is, a person should have in the country, the people should have a decent standard life. Decent standard life, they are having a good health conditions as well as ability to have a healthy life. Ability to have healthy life, and the life expectancy will be more there. And second factor is the literacy level. Literacy level of the people in that country. And third concept is the income to purchase basic needs of the life. If these criteria, we can measure a development of a country. And similarly, Amartya Sen tells about the capabilities. According to him, in a country, the people should have a capability or ability to have a good health as well as literacy as well as even the purchasing power. If they are having these capabilities or abilities, that will, on the basis of this one, we can measure the development of a particular country. And here, the same ideas what were put forward by Mahbub ul Haq as well as Amartya Sen, the same ideas were taken into consideration. There is a UNDP. UNDP means United Nations Development, that is a progress. This UNDP taken into consideration the ideas which were put forward by those economists, and according to them, HDI, Human Development Index, that is measured on the basis of health measures. And how can Which factor will help to know about the health measure? Means the life expectancy. What is life expectancy? The average life of a particular person is to expected to live in a particular country, that may be 60 years, 65 years. That is the life expectancy. On the basis of that one, we can measure the development in that country. And second factor is the education. Means a minimum education every person in that country should have, that is attained. That is the minimum schooling of a particular person. That is the second thing. They also put forward the third thing, that is the purchasing power or purchasing power and the per capita income and ability to purchase the various basic amenities or basic needs of the life. And average of these three, that is a health, education and purchasing power, and average of this is responsible to measure. By having the average of these three factors, we can measure the development of a particular person or a particular country, and that can be measured with the help of these three factors, that is the human development index. On this basis, we can compare the one country's HDI with another country's HDI, and they, we can put a particular country in a developed stage or underdeveloped stage or developing stage on the basis of human development index. So in this manner, in our India according to 2012 and later in 2014, a figure was came out. According to that one, here our index, HDI of India was 0.586, and our position in the world countries is 135 ranking among 187 countries. And on this basis, we can say that our India is not in a very highest manner, that is in 0.9 category countries, developed countries, and not even in a low condition, 0.1 or 2. We are in a middle position, 0.5. That's why according to this report, we can say that our India is a developing country and in a middle position, because if we classify the HDI, on the basis of HDI, the countries into high as well as medium as well as even the low, our India is in the medium position. It is about the development as well as even the meaning and various indicators and other parameters of development. Next concept of this chapter is the last concept is gender related development. Here in the previous chapters also already explained about this gender concept. The gender means men and women. Gender development or gender related development. Here we are going to know about the development of women. Gender related development. Women, the development of women is very important in economy, because she constitute nearly 50% of the population of a country. If the participation and the development of women is good one, then the country also can develop. Here it is the responsibility of every, that is society. The society is to encourage, society encourage the women, encourage women to participate in the political, economic, social and every field. They should give an opportunities to participate as well as develop, and because their development is also responsible for the development of a country. Here, this here in our Indian constitution, even in the previous chapters also you came to know that our Indian constitution is providing various type of facilities. Constitution providing provisions for the development of women, like the concept of equality all men and women are equal, equal opportunities are given for the men and women, and the concept of freedom, even men and women are free to, that is, adopt any profession, any kind of occupation, and lead for the economic development. Means there are provisions are there and encouragement is there. This is the condition. But even having these kind of facilities, the woman is also facing the problem of discrimination. Problem of discrimination. Women is discriminated even today. We are living in a very technical age as well as advanced age. Then also, women is facing the problem of discrimination. Particularly in which manner, in which fields she is facing the problem of discrimination. First one is how you can come to know about this one is the sex ratio. Sex ratio, the women population is less when we compare to the men population, because here the people give more importance to the boy child than the girl child. That's why women ratio is decreasing. According to 2011 census, what is the ratio? For every 1000 men, the women is 945. It means the shortage of 65, and it is a shortage of bride for the bridegrooms. Here that is different story. Here sex ratio is one of the important type of discrimination. Next is the literacy. When we come to know about the literacy level of the women, the only, that is 65.46% of the women are literate according to 2011 census. When we compare to the men, they are more than 80%, and they are in a 65. It is also a type of discrimination. And here other one is the lower wages. Lower wages, the wages which are given for the women is less in the unorganized sector. When we compare to the men, the wages are very less. Particularly when we give example of our own area, the woman is given 250 rupees per day and men is given 500 rupees, and other incentives also given to them. It is a kind of discrimination, lower wages. And even whatever they earn the wages, they are not free to spend that one. Not free to spend their own earnings. Whatever they earn the money, the same money they cannot spend independently. They have to depend upon the male people or male persons in the society. And here there is they are lost to eat in the house. Here a woman, she prepares the food and everything, and she has to serve the food for the elders of the family and children of the family, and in the last stage she has to take the food, and sometime there will be deficiency of food, and that lead to the various problems like malnutrition. Here malnutrition as well as hunger, and further that will take to a problem to the even the death of the women and the death of the children. So all those are the various effects of this loss to eat and malnutrition, and that is the another problem. And next is here the evil practices of female foeticide, that is a female foeticide or female infanticide, killing the foetus of a child or foetus of a child in the womb of a mother, that is called as female foeticide. It is also a kind of discrimination. There is a different kind of methods in order to identify the foetus. If it is found of a girl, that will be killed in the womb itself, and it is of a boy, that will be left. Here this is a kind of discrimination which is also responsible for the here various problems in the society. And here these problems are there, means we have to find out the solution for these problems. What are the solutions for the problem of this discrimination? There are various solutions are there. First of all, we representation in political bodies. Here representation is given to them in the village panchayat, zilla panchayat, taluk panchayat, and even in the town municipalities, corporations, everywhere the representation is given for the upliftment of the women. And other one is self-help groups means the various women organizations and groups like Stri Shakti and here a group of 20 women come together and consolidate their savings and put for the business and many kind of the habits, business habits and tactics they learn in the self-help group, the bank activities, account maintaining and even advertising the goods and various activities they learn with their self-help group. It is also a kind of that is and even infuse power, giving a power to them and having that power they can consolidate their power as well as increase their ability and even access to resources. Access to resources, here women is given access or control over the various type of resources and even the curb violence against women. Means any type of violence which is taking place against women, that may be in the home as well as even the working places, such kind of violence to be curbed. And here steps are taken by the government and various organizations in order to prevent this kind of discrimination. Okay, here this is the last concept of this chapter. Till now, to some extent, I am maybe able to reach you with these all important concepts. And further, we are going to the other chapters. If you find any doubt in this chapter, you can give in comments as well as for more videos, subscribe this channel as well as show your likes. Okay.